I think it's a great start. And Partha, I want to come next to you. And you are again part of a big conglomerate. And while we battle the crisis, while we battle the here and now, and Vivek was giving a sense of really some of the near-term challenges, how do you think companies can plan for a better turnaround? Because this crisis will continue in some shape and size for some time. So how do you think that companies could be thinking of a sharper turnaround? And if you were to advise the CXOs of different companies, what should be the top three priorities that they should collectively think and own? That perspective would be very useful. So Partha, all yours.
Thank you. Thank you, Prabir. And I hope I'm audible. Yeah, okay. So I can see that. And I think Vivek gave a very nice way to kind of start this off by saying that we are dealing with an unknown unknown. You know, it's therefore you, if you were to say, I have a playbook and you should do this, then it'll not be there quite the right way to look at it. The key thing is that you've got to engage with this whole aspect and then try to look outward and look at scenarios. So in a sense, I would like to, you know, first of all, say hello to all our viewers and also tell them that look at mine in relative terms and not absolute, whatever I say. And therefore apply that in that context to each, because each one of us are like the people experiencing the elephant. And if we are all blind and we are experiencing the elephant, it will seem very different parts will seem different things to different people. So keep that in mind even as I kind of try to answer, because Mr. Prabir asked the question, I can't not answer it. So I'll give my views on this. So Vivek, like you, let me start with a slogan. I said, I think we should look at it in three forms. Whenever a crisis hits you, how do you respond or react is the first one. The second one is how do you respond to the ecosystem? You know, how do you think about it? And third is how do you renew yourself? And that's what you are talking about. How do I come back better than what I started off? So I think I'll give these three as a way. If anybody wants to do a faster turnaround, they can look at it in terms of how do you react, how do you respond, how do you renew. So the first aspect that I have to worry about is my ecosystem. Okay, I stopped talking about cash because cash is king, and you'll all say, first is make sure you don't run out of cash. As a CFO, that was the thing I kind of said till my voice was hoarse. And now it's not even a king, cash, it's an emperor. But if you were to look at protecting value chain, that's the first reaction that we must have. Because if we don't protect our value chain, the recovery time may come and you find that you are in an island, you are okay, but your ecosystem is not okay. And then how do you restart the engine faster? So therefore, the first thing I would say is how do you protect your value chain? And each one of us must decide what our value chain is, which are the people who are most impacted, and then how do we partner these people? So one is, I'll just give an example. Mahindra First Choice Wheels, which has got franchisees out there for used car. We had a town hall with all the dealers and put them a 10-point program of how we can help them during this time. It's very important. Those people, dealers outside there, sitting there, will be feeling very alone and not knowing how to respond alone. But the moment we form a chain that we are together, then it can be much bigger. The second one is, once the lockdown is there, think of how we will quickly upturn. So that means, have you oiled all the machinery? Have you done all the things which needs to be done so that, you know, it's like our car. We go once a week and tune it up, right? Even though we are not driving it now. How do I tune my company's engine every week, periodically, so that when I start to open, then it opens faster, and now I don't have a dead battery, so I have to get somebody to jumpstart it before I can drive. Yeah. So this is the second thing I would suggest to anybody. And third is that everyone should come together, which is robust and ready for the economy pickup. So read the news, connect every periodically to see what the new thing bring. Because if the government gives a plan, then it has a set of reaction which it sets in. how do we take advantage of that reaction? How do we come on top? So this is the first part. The second part is that the organization must learn from this and in future must tackle the unknown unknowns better. But we tackle unknown unknowns not by having saying this is how in future we will tackle it, but by changing our thing to saying we know how to adapt. Praveer, if I'm going to write a book soon and that book's title will not be Built to Last, the title of the book will be Built to Adapt. So why Built to Adapt is because the future again will have a black swan event and we don't know what that event is. But we must know how to adapt to that one. So I was thinking about, for example, COVID-19 was never captured in any risk matrix, right? It just came up in everybody's risk matrix after the event has happened. Okay, we can be forgiven for reactionary adapting, but we must learn from this and therefore put it. So is there an SOP like a SWAT team? Any emergency come, here are the 10 people. Here is how the business continuity will happen. Here is how I will put in. So if you put this, so even while restarting, this same set of SWAT team can keep giving us input of how to do. So this is, I call the A team, which will help us start faster and start better. The third part is that I think, and that's the most important to my mind, every crisis gives opportunity. Have you put a separate team called the B team out there? I called A does A and B does B. This is some famous book and writer who has given this slogan, right? And Praveer, you are HR, so you must know this, okay? So this B does B, if you put, have you put a team which is only looking at how do we come out of this better? What is the new adaptation? Take, for example, TVS. They say, I'm going to do 75% from home year after, even after the crisis is gone. So is this giving them a new cost paradigm? New business model paradigm. And therefore, that is the third part that one needs to look at. And therefore, I would say, look at bringing new business model. Look at how will we be digitally be more savvy. And this team has nothing to do with the day-to-day operation. Take them out, put them separately and tell them to bring out this stuff. If you do these three measures, I think we should come out a little better when we come out of the priority. The next question you asked is three priorities for CXOs, okay? So that I don't keep talking for a very long time because you have given me a blank canvas and I can paint for the next 45 minutes. But I would take a smaller bite at this and maybe later if somebody wants to expand, I can do. I first say that cash flow, focus on cash flow. And priority, your priority is don't run out of cash. If you run out of cash, all the other things won't matter for a thing. So again, even though it is often repeated, it's worth repeating. Cash is blood of any business. Cash is today emperor. Focus on it and work out the worst scenarios and work out and do. I've told people, withdraw money and keep it under your pillow. It's better than saying when you need it and go to the bank, you may find the bank is not lending you anymore. So be very clear about how your sources of money and manage cash flows for the next 6 months better. And assume the worst and plan for the best. The second is, it is very important to focus on employee. The business will be focused on by the employees provided you focus on the business. So if for one thing, if you have to do, focus on your employees' well-being. And I think they are very scared. They may be very unsure of the future. And therefore, you must focus on them and do many things, not just do exercises and IT training, but give them this, best innovation can you bring about. B does B, form teams in each place of B does B and say, what are the new ideas you can bring about? And engage them so that every day their mind is not an empty mind. And it's a devil's workshop then, right? So, and the last one is community support. Okay. Community support, I think Praveer, you are trying to say something.
No, I was only trying to say that I'll come back on the employees bit separately with you in just a while, but please do continue.
Yeah, so I'll just finish in this and community support. See, basically, we all talk about philosophy saying we are a great company, we do this and we do this for everyone. This is the time to prove it. So therefore, how are you looking at community support? your brand name will be remembered, how you handle this crisis. Yeah, so therefore, look at community and look at what we stand up to our visions. We stand up to our missions. This is the time to showcase that in practical terms. Okay, and therefore, that will be very important. So do that. I will add a fourth. Please ensure B does B. That's our salvation as we go forward. So this is the thing, and I'll stop here and say, okay. You asked me for three CFO, CXO things. I've given you three plus one.
Very succinct. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.